والنهايات بسيط حكيم. أستغفر الله الذي أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين، واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. رب يسر ولا تعسر وتمرن بالخير وبك نستعين يا فتاح يا فتاح يا فتاح. صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم الأمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Alhamdulillah, it's a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given me and you the ability and tawfiq to participate in this gathering. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this gathering a source of guidance for all of us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this gathering one of the means of our entry into Jannah. Inshallah, tonight, I will try to bring the whole discussion together. If you remember, I started this discussion by sharing the four attitudes that I developed towards Islam. My first attitude was that this religion that I'm believing in, this religion is outdated. And I will give you some examples, inshallah, tonight, which will help you understand that it's still relevant. It's not outdated. It doesn't belong to the ancient times. The second attitude that I developed towards my religion was that it's very harsh. And if you remember, last night, the only thing we discussed is that Islam is not harsh. We Muslims make it harsh. And I mentioned a couple of examples from the seerah, from the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My third attitude was that it is unfair. There are many things about Islam that when you first hear them, it disturbs you. But then I said that if you understand the text with wisdom, then you will actually understand the text. Then it will look really beautiful to you. We have confused being able to cite the text with the analysis of the text and understanding the text, the wisdom of the text. We think that everyone who can, or anyone who can cite the text, he can actually understand the text. And I mentioned one example, if you remember. Because there is a big debate about how the testimony of a woman is just half of that of a man. How a testimony of a woman is half that of a man. And I mentioned that example yesterday. A brother came to me yesterday and he said, Mulana, if you can explain it to us in Punjabi a bit. In a bit Punjabi, so that we can understand that wisdom. So I will explain it one more time. Not in Punjabi, but I will mix some Punjabi with it. What I was saying yesterday is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that woman's testimony is only half of that of a man, it's a time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about business transactions, loan transactions. When it comes to your business transactions, when it comes to your loans transactions, then Allah says, okay, one man and how many women? Two women. Why? Because Allah knows that this is your ma'amala. This is your dealing with each other. And when it comes to your dealings, when it comes to your businesses, you are never going to trust your buddhi. Buddhiya dekhati pro sani karna tuse. Allah knew it. That you are never going to trust your women. So that's why Allah put this condition. But when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah trusts women. And Allah trusts the testimony of women. That's why Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, more than half of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming from Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, the testimony of one woman, and it's good enough for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we understand this now, alhamdulillah. I have a friend in Pakistan, and he's a doctor, mashallah. He's working in psychotherapy nowadays. And this year when I was in Pakistan, he told me that he spent 2 years in Jamia Shafia. Jamia Shafia is a study, it's an Islamic university. So he said, I spent 2 years in Jamia Shafia studying the tafsir of Quran. Do we all know what tafsir means? Yeah. Explanation of the Quran, right? So he said, I spent 2 years in Jamia Shafia studying the tafsir of Quran and also maqasid shar'iyya. Maqasid shar'iyya means the logic or the wisdom behind the text. So he spent 2 years studying it. And now he's a doctor and he's working in psychotherapy. He said, I take concepts from the Quran and present them at my hospital training without telling people that these are the concepts from Quran. And my colleagues who are way more qualified than I am, they are raging. They are in shock. Where are you getting these concepts from? And he gave me an example. He said, recently there was a study of people who spend more time staring in the sky. These people who spend more time staring in the sky, these people are more at peace with themselves. less stress and they are more generous. And Allah says, أَفَلَا يَنْزُرُونَ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَوْقَهُمْ بَنَيْنَاهَا وَزَيَّنَّاهَا وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ كَيْفَ رُفِعَتْ. Allah is telling us again and again in the Quran, why don't you look at the sky? It will give you peace. Why don't you look at the sky? There are passages in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about spending and looking at the sky. And people are doing studies on that. But by the way, we Muslims are not doing any studies. We are not doing. We Muslims, when we come across such kind of studies, what do we say? Alhamdulillah. It's already mentioned in the Quran. MashaAllah. Nare Takbir. That's what we say. It's already mentioned in the Quran. We're never going to do anything about it. But Alhamdulillah. So my four attitudes that I developed, that I mentioned in the beginning, they were not the problem of Islam. Unfortunately, they are problem of unfair, unintelligent, disingenuous representation of Islam. So it's high time for the Muslim community, especially in the West. It's high time for you, who is trying to come back to their senses, you take control now. And you put the best of our people, the smartest of our people, the smartest of our intellectuals, the smartest of our scholars. You put this responsibility on them of teaching Islam to your children, to your young people, the way it is supposed to be taught. And not just teaching the way it is supposed to be taught, meaning writing another PhD thesis, or writing another book, or a 4-hour long fatwa. You know, because it's never going to reach 16-year-old. It's never going to reach 16-year-old. My old 16-year-old self, my old 18-year-old self, I was never interested in fatwa. Never. By the way, I was Hafiz and I was in Pakistan. But still I was never interested in fatwa. And I can say it fatwa because I was born in Pakistan and knew Urdu. You guys, when read the word fatwa, what do you say? What is this? Fatwa? Fatwa? Right? So we can't even understand the word, let alone understanding it, right? We can't even say the word. Yeah, I would be interested in going and watching a movie. I would be interested in going and playing a video game. So now I have this concept in my mind. And this is the last example I will share with you, inshallah. I have a concept in my mind. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that things like that, you know, it starts getting materialized soon, inshallah. You know, nowadays there is a lot of talk that how youngsters are turning to extremism. And they are being drawn to militant rhetoric. You know, there's a huge discussion, especially in the West, especially in this part of the country. There's a huge discussion about it. So what if you make a movie? Quran is saying movie, astaghfirullah, right? Don't worry, I'm not talking about Bollywood movie. Hear me out first. What if you make a movie of bunch of guys, and you know, these bunch of guys, they are arrested. And they are thrown into some kind of prison. Now, some of these guys are arrested because they really wanted to blow something else. They really wanted to blow something up. But some of these guys are arrested because they were falsely accused. They are good practicing Muslims, they are good kids, but they don't have any such aspirations. But they all got arrested. Now, these kids, super jihadi militant kids, and the kids who are level-headed, they all are together sitting in a jail cell together. All of them. They all are sitting together in a jail cell. Maybe one and two other scholars as well. Now you tell me, do they all see Islam in the same way? Do they all see Islam in the same way? No, they don't, right? But they have to spend time together in a jail cell for more than a year. Now guess what? They start talking about how they see Islam. And they start arguing. And the discussion becomes really heated. And they are arguing and they are presenting all of their dalail. Now if you take all of these dalail, you take all of these arguments and put them together in a big heavy book, are you going to read them? Are you going to read them? No, you never. You know, I'm a student of knowledge. I'm interested in reading. But I won't be able to survive past the second page. But what if you take, if you make a movie out of it? What if you make a TV show out of it? What if you make a compelling film out of it? Then what? Then you guys are going to say, dude, did you see that movie? It was crazy. Some brothers told Mulana never said, never use the word crazy, use the word sick. It was sick. It was crazy. Yeah? Because that's what we want. And by the way, this idea, it's not a modern, liberal, progressive idea. This idea of presenting Islamic concepts through creative media, it's a concept of Quran. Now you tell me, is it outdated? Does it belong to ancient times? Huh? Let me give you an example. At the lead, we all know this surah by heart, most of us. وَالْعَادِيَاتِ ضَبْحًا فَالْمُورِيَاتِ قَدْحًا فَالْمُغِيرَاتِ سُبْحًا فَأَثَرْنَ بِهِ نَقْعًا فَوَسَطْنَ بِهِ جَمْعًا. These ayat of Surah Adiyat have nothing to do with Akhirah. These ayat of Surah Adiyat have nothing to do with the Day of Judgment. These ayat of Surah Adiyat have nothing to do with the companions of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These ayat have nothing to do with Jihad fi sabilillah, fighting in the path of Allah, because this surah is a Makki surah, Madani surah. It's a Makki surah. Do you remember any conflict happening between Muslims and non-Muslims in the Makkan period? Conflicts start happening in which period?
Madani period.
In the Madani period. In Makki period, are there any conflicts? No. Are there any fightings? No. The surah is revealed in which period? So this surah is not about fighting in the path. This is not about jihad. All of these ayat had to do with epic horses fighting in the battle. Like an action film. And you know, if Arab loves something, it was an action film. And if it has horses, then wow, it's like Fast and Furious. Right? Why do I say Fast and Furious? Yeah, this is the reality. It's like Fast and Furious. It took their attention. Quran took their attention. You know, Allah understands there are things in us that captivates our mind, that wants to be entertained. Allah knows that. And you know, if you just study the imagery of these verses of the Quran, it's remarkably entertaining. If some young people, creative young Muslim people, if they want to make something out of it, they can make an epic trailer out of it. You know how you see horses are running, and there are swords and spears are ready, and the enemy are on one side waiting, and as the clash is about to happen, then what happened? Everything is cut. Right? And then we say, yeah, we have to watch that movie, right? These are the verses of the Quran. That's always teaching us. SubhanAllah. You don't only have to learn what Quran says, you also have to learn how Quran is teaching you. Allah has a divine way of teaching you Quran. And you have to understand that. You internalize that and then translate in how we are going to teach Quran to our children. That's how we need to teach Quran to our children. And by the way, brothers, by the way, and I'm really honest here, this responsibility is squarely on the shoulder of you Muslims who are living in the West. Because the Muslim world, most of the Muslim world, they are literally on fire. And there are people in Muslim world who have fire raging inside them. You know, if I was doing this taqaleer, if I was doing this speech in Pakistan, I would be dead in the first 5 minutes. I would be dead in the first 5 minutes. And I'm not exaggerating. I'm telling you honestly. So this responsibility is upon you. You people are the future of this world. Take this responsibility. How are we going to take this responsibility? This leads me to my another topic, inshallah. And that's what I will start from tomorrow, inshallah. How the youngsters of this ummah can become the asset of this ummah. How can they attain guidance in their youthful years? So I request all of you brothers, kindly keep coming and participating in that gathering. You never know, this month of Ramadan, it changes our life, inshallah. Are we ready for this night, inshallah? And let me know, whenever you get bored of it, let me know, I'll be changing the topic, inshallah.